Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of Banished with me, Vapor. Just a couple of things before we get into the episode. I've hurt my right hand, so that I'm right-handed, and that'd be my mouse hand. I've pulled a tendon in what would kind of be the finger that controls my left click, so that's why I've kind of not made a video for a couple of days. It's still a little bit painful, but, you know, I'm living with it, and using a mouse isn't going to strain it too much. What else? Excuse me for how I'm going to pronounce this. Eklig von Liechtenstein asked what mods I was using. So I'm going to post them in the description of the video, and I'll put them in the order that I load them as well, because certain mods need to be loaded in different orders of other things, and clearly they're working for me, so I would assume if you load them in the same way, you shouldn't have any issues with that. So I will do that in the description. Also, in episode 1 of this series, I asked if everyone could give the video a like, because I'd like to make it the most liked video on my channel, and that's now happened. When I last checked, it had 67 likes, and that's the most liked video I've ever had, so thank you so much for that. It's absolutely fantastic, and I think as of today we're at 522 subscribers, which is pretty impressive. I was thinking of doing something for 500 subscribers, but I'm not too sure what to do other than say thank you. And I know most people watch my Banished series as opposed to anything else that I do. I mean, I know some of you will have subscribed for other videos of other games that I've played, but I think the vast majority is because of Banished. So if I say thank you here, I know most of you will actually kind of see it. I might do something a little bit further along the line for that, but I'm not going to make a video specific to that. I might do it at 1,000 if and when we get there. We're kind of on the way there, so I guess it could happen anytime soon. Just one thing while we're doing this episode, and if I do another one today, maybe that episode too. It's quite hot here at the moment. It's a little bit later in the day, but it's very humid, so although I don't have a fan on, my computer's going a little bit kind of on overdrive, let's say, because it's a lot hotter than it should be. I do have a window open, and I live on a fairly busy road, so you might hear, like, well, you do anyway, but you might hear more like cars going past and things like that. I'll edit them out where I can. If I'm in the middle of speech like I am now, it's a little bit harder to edit out without me kind of repeating everything I've said. And let's have a quick look at this. Ooh, let's pause the game. We can't afford any of this, but this is good stuff. Is this stuff I've asked for it to bring? No. I really need to look into this stuff. No, I'm going to keep him here because watermelon is something we need. What can we actually trade? What have we got a lot of nothing. Let's keep it anyway, because the watermelon seeds would be useful for this climate. Kraljuk also pointed out that I forgot to mention the dock bridge, which generally looks like the normal dock, but as a bridge. Apparently someone requested a bridge to be made out of the dock, so I think, you know, it looks cool in its own right, but I guess couldn't you just do the docks? I don't know. I'm not too sure. I'm going to remove it anyway, because I only built it to kind of show you. Right, what we're going to do in this episode is, I'll leave it paused just for a second. We've got tools. We're still struggling a little bit on the cloves front, so that's leather. Just want to have a quick look. Not that cloves are really an issue when you're in a hot climate like this. So what are we getting from here? We're getting a little bit of leather from there. I'm guessing this is wool mostly, and a little bit of leather. And that's feathers and eggs. Now, I could build more of these, and I might be inclined to do that, but if we have a quick look, I could switch to wool coats, because we're making more of that. What I would like to see, if you are listening, Kraljuk, is on some of the items, it says how much of each unit you would need. So let's say if it was this one, reeds and feathers, it would say reeds and maybe like 3 next to it, and then feathers and say 4. It'd be interesting to know the numbers that you need to see which one's more efficient. It's probably on your forum somewhere, but I'm being lazy. Right, we'll switch that to wool for now. Tools were fine. Food, where's our town hall? Let's have a quick look. Okay, I'll pause for a second. I'm going to have to edit that motorbike out that went past. So 4.5, 6. Okay, that's not too bad, actually. We still need this. Where are we? Families, 33. So we need quite a few homes. So what I'm thinking is, let's get rid of this little market here. And we're going to start building our main town around this area. Kind of the market area. I will rejig this later on to be something else. Like we've kind of discussed already, like the town hall and the church. I don't quite know how we'll do it. It might become an industry area and I might move the town hall altogether. But let's go with the market. And let's get this area up and running. So we're going to continue with the sandstone roads because I think they just absolutely work perfect in this sand. There we go. Now I'd like to probably do this a little bit different than how I would usually do it because it's getting a bit repetitive how I put my little plants in. I guess we got palm trees and stuff. Well, we short of stone. Well, that's not surprising. Let's get down a stockpile. We'll go with a generic one. Just so they've got somewhere to dump all this stuff. Where can we put it? I might just sneak it in here. Don't want it too big. That'll do nicely. And we will link a sandstone road to the main town. Let's have a... How long is this? Is it actually 14? So if we're going with a double road, it needs to be at the next square. So here and here. So we'll shoot that straight through. So we're definitely going to move those houses at some point, because they're going to be in the way. Okay. So what are we doing for food? We've got this place here, haven't we? Yep. And we're producing a little bit of milk and eggs. Well, let's have a look in the red ketchup buildings, because I know he's got various things here. Creamery. Okay, so we could use that. Drying shack. Apiary. Now, there's one thing we've not built. That might be quite useful. Water tower. Butcher shop. Bakery. I reckon, let's have a look at this building. Now I think the only difference between this and me using the one that comes with Colonial Charter, that's tinned. Where is it? Is it this one? Okay, so that takes 60 and 14. Let me pause it because that trade is going to go. And this one takes a little bit of less and a little bit more, depends how you look at that. Now let's look at this model. Okay. What about this one? That's preservist. I think I prefer this one. So I think we're going to put this kind of over here, next to the river. Which way is the, which is the front of this building? We'll go with that, I think. I think we'll go about there, and we'll build some more of these around here later on, I think. Oh yeah, let's have a see look. See look? Let's have a look at what this trade has got. Is that what you're offering me, really? Okay, but this could be good for later on, so let's have a... Building supplies, because I don't intend on actually making them. What else have we got? Because I'm going to be lazy, basically. Like I did in the, towards the end of the last series, I kind of started just importing these things. Because it just made more sense to me. Jade statue, leather, lumber. Yeah. Although I know we can make that at the moment. Okay, we'll probably just go with that for the moment. We'll change that later on. Okay. I'm in this habit of pausing a game when I move because I was so used to it lagging in the previous series because it got so big. Right, so how are we going to decorate this? What have we got? We had some new stuff, didn't we? Definitely going to use palm trees. We're going to use those camels at some point as well, probably in this area. So I think I'm doing a little bit of a trade post somewhere nearby. Um, looking at the river. I guess a small boat could venture its way up that river, couldn't it? It's not... We might kind of do a very little makeshift kind of harbour here. In fact, let's have a quick look at... Where is it? Some of the buildings I've not used before, like the Bootlegger or something like that. Chartered Company, what's that? Is that... Okay. Yeah, we could probably get away with something. I don't want the native one. I reckon we could probably get away with putting that on there and setting up like a little trade route kind of through to the marketplace, and we can use some camels and stuff and some tents. We'll make that look like it's like a trade route off the main river. I think that's what we'll do there. Like, although it won't serve any specific purpose, you know me. I like to make things look good. We've got you there on purpose, haven't we? Eggs? What are we going to do with eggs? I don't know. Right, we've got three people in here producing not enough stone, so I can put five in. Who's living in these houses? So stonecutter, trader, child and a child. Trader, builder. Probably need a couple more houses over this side, actually. So let's go with that first. Salt box. Is it a salt box? Yeah. Okay, we'll do four, and then we might do a bit of a gap. One, two, three, four. Maybe about there. Leave a bit of a gap. We might actually make this a mining area and use some of those new cranes. Why not? Okay, so the main thing we're waiting for is stone, but thinking about this logically, got a little bit of stone laying around in this area, so let's just clear some of that. Right, we're going to do this like a proper market area, and we will take advantage of buildings in bulk, because we've got the mini buildings as well, haven't we? I think, well, if we, anything in here that would look interesting. Let's get to an area where it's clear so I can see what we're looking at. That's just a fisherman. Okay. Gatherer. Mini herbalist. I kind of like that. Trade post. See, they're quite nice too. Although that's a hospital, that might look good by the trading area. Okay. Red ketchup. Right. Blacksmith. Can't do anything with a tavern yet. Holy moly, that's big. Windmill. Not a bad building there either, with Taylor. Sorry, I'm just gonna familiarizing myself with some of these things. Okay. Bakery. Where's the trader ones? Let's have a, what have we got here? So hardware store. So is this, okay, it's like a marketplace but specific. Yeah. I think we will go with some of these buildings. General store, I like it. Okay. That holds ale, okay. Food. Most of these don't need a lot of materials, which is quite nice. Makes it a little bit easy, I suppose. Do I need an extra road going around there? I think we might do. Because I don't quite know how I'm going to decorate it yet, so... Let's just put another one around. Those rocks are going to get in the way a little bit. Okay. Let's go with the removal of both. We'll just grab that little bit of iron that's in the way as well. Okay, let's see. I think we go with... You ain't got grain yet. We ain't got fruit. Hardware store. So stone, iron and wood, so that would be quite useful. Again, I might set these back a little bit because I'm not quite sure how I will decorate around them. Set them back by two. Cloth vendor. Hopefully these kind of... match up quite well. I'm assuming they're a very similar size. What else have we got? Pie, tells meat, nuts and protein. So that should hold fish at the very minimum. What have we got? A general store. Right, that's going to leave one gap. How irritating is that? It's quite annoying. Okay, we're going to have to deal with that slightly different way, I think. So if we got in, we got... Okay, so we need cloth. It's kind of funny how these things irritate me. It has to match up. Right. So we can put this one over here. 1, 2. And what else have we got? Food store. Okay, that's a little one. Uh-huh. We could probably use that. Medieval food store. Meat. That's a tiny one as well. I don't know. What have we got here? General store. I think we'll put the meat one in. So, 1, 2. That should be about there. Right, we'll let those build. Now, further back, we can build some more houses, because I do need houses nearby. I think. Well, I don't think I know. So, I'm going to try and make this... A lot of people say to me, oh, it's not very efficient. You don't build efficient towns. I'm going to try and at least build something that resembles an efficient town. Try being the word there. I think it's going to be a double road as well. Okay. 1, 2, 1, 2. What have I done wrong there then? Maybe the buildings are all completely different sizes. Oh, this isn't... 13. By 14. Ah, it's a slightly different size. Okay. Fair enough. Just to annoy me and my OCD. I've been looking at Stellaris. I know I struggle to keep up with the videos I actually do on the channel as it is, but I think City Skylines, I'm going to continue it, but I've kind of made a promise to myself, and I've mentioned this before, that I'm probably going to stick to one city building game at a time, because they're very time consuming. And as Banished is the one I'm probably the best at, and obviously a lot of you seem to appreciate the videos that I do on Banished, that one will be a permanent feature, and I think I've said that before. But Stellaris is something a little bit more close to my heart. I like space and I like science fiction. So I'm possibly thinking about getting that. I've chucked it on my wish list anyway on Steam, so we'll see. It's all about time and money and all those things. The wonderful things we have in life. Let's speed this up. I thought that was a little bit slow. Okay, let's chuck some more builders in. How are we doing over here for clothes now that we're using wool? Oh, we're actually getting some. Okay. I think everything else is doing quite well. Let's finish some of this over here. While they're all running around like crazed people. So where's my palm trees? Is that banana tree? Oh, that's quite nice. I like that. A yucca tree. And there's various different models for that. Is that all of them? I think it is. But this one I like because there's various different ones. So let's... I don't know if I'm going to put anything else in here. But we can probably get away with one of these slightly taller... palm trees just down the side here. And we'll put one of those in there. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo decisions. I think we'll go with a slightly longer one. Oh, I like that. There we go. We'll probably put some more decorations in here. What about cats and dogs? What about camel? I'm obsessed with a camel. What kind of animals would you have in this environment when you think about it? What are we growing here, barley? Other than camels. I don't think much else would survive very well. What we could do, let's have a see. got various plants, haven't we? Oh, we're in autumn, so I guess the leaves still fall off the trees, even though it's not actually autumn. But I guess we could use this tool, which I've not used yet, and do different like patterns and things like that. We actually got grass in here.
Ooh.
That would be a precious resource in the desert, wouldn't it? Okay, how are we doing over here? We're getting there slowly with that. Probably because our houses are so far away. Have I gonna build? I have. What an idiot. Built my stockpile right in the way of the path. So that's gonna have to be moved. Tools closed. Everything's looking good. Apart from the fact we haven't got enough houses yet. Food. Probably check that after this, after winter has gone by. Oh, lumber. Okay. I'll switch that back on. You can go back to work. Make us some lumber. Still not making enough stone. What are we doing here? We probably full on dry goods, aren't we? Dry goods, dry goods. Oh, no. What is the issue then? Fuel limit. Aha, fuel limit's at that. At its maximum. Well, I'm not going to increase that because we don't want to produce it just for the hell of it. Although we could sell it. What's it worth? 3. I think firewood is worth 4, if I remember right. So we're going to need an awful lot to trade for this kind of stuff. Yeah. That is a predicament. We'll probably do some stone statues and I don't think we can do jade. Can't remember. Right, we'll chuck someone in there. We should have some milk lingering around. What have we got in here? Well, we got feathers. Where's milk? Yeah, we've got a little bit of milk. Probably not enough. But it's a start. Here we go. What have we got here? Oh, these different models as well. To which we need bricks. Stop being greedy. You only want one person in there. Same here for now. We're really going to have to try out some of these builders and just have a go of them and see what they're like. Right, where's our front door? Oh, we can't build right up to it. That's unusual, isn't it? You see, that's where maybe the likes of Kralyug have been a little bit more thoughtful. Red ketchup hasn't, unfortunately. Oh no, never mind. I can live with it. Okay, so we'll switch this down to 1. Same with this one. Oh, we got some nomads. Ooh. I totally forgot about those guys. Let's go and have a look. How many have we got? 8. It's a bit pointless, isn't it? We don't really need them. And they're probably going to cause me more trouble. And they're worth actually trouble. Well, I think it was Noble Rambler that said it. Sometimes the trouble is what makes an episode fun. So there we go. That's for you, Noble. If it all goes wrong and pear-shaped, I'm going to knock on your door. Watermelon seeds. Let's see how much we've actually got. So 500. And 29 of those. Yeah, nowhere near enough. Oh my god. We really need to kind of think about something we can trade for. Okay, these guys have absolutely got nowhere to live. But we've got some. I'm tempted to put some more houses over there. I might even put a house in here. Let's have a look. What would look nice here? A log cabin look nice? That's the old school houses. Wow. Takes me back. Not really a big fan of that one. I like these ones. And that one might kind of go with the buildings. One of these got wood. Nope. Oh, somebody's died. Okay, I think. Might go with a country house. It's got a similar tile as well. Might go with that one. Let's put my house somewhere nearby. So I'm trying to think, because I'm trying to think into the future, what we're going to do next. I reckon. We put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all different colours, and we'll probably put some more of these. In fact, we'll probably move that over here. Plus, these guys can wander around anyway. I don't know if it might kind of take care of the nomads. Right, has this been removed? It has. Let's get the road in. Quick look over my left shoulder tells me we're 25 minutes in, which means we're about up on our time. But I'm going to continue a little bit longer. The only reason I only do episodes for about 20 minutes, apart from the fact it keeps people's attention, is the fact that it takes a lot longer to render the longer the video goes on. What you guys are thinking of this so far? I think the reason I've done the road this little bit bigger is because if I've done it right, we can put some palm trees and stuff through the middle. I don't go too crazy on the flower beds like I did before, but we'll probably use... Where are they? Why is my brain going dead? Here we are. Yeah, we'll probably use these sort of things. And we'll plant some palm trees and make it look a little bit more... A bit more kind of deserty, if that's a word. Should I probably have a look at some pictures of like Dubai and stuff? I know that place is like mega rich and they've got grass everywhere for a desert, but might give me some inspiration. Or even just general desert places where people live. So see what kind of ideas I get. But I think we're good trying to make this a little bit more modern. For the time of the game, anyway. What do these buildings need? Oh, I didn't really think about that, did I? Oh, pain. Okay. Well, we're not building those then. We have to go back to the old trusty red ketchup houses. Never mind. People are going to be like, well, you know, you should have set up a production chain. You try to think you're clever by buying everything in. You can't buy everything because you haven't got the stuff to do it with. And simple answer to that is yes, I know. Actually, we're putting up a mine in while I think about it. Where are they? Drain here. Where's it? Stone. There we are. Leave a little bit of a space between these two. Oh, I don't want to go past that. Maybe about there. And then I'm probably going to duplicate them the opposite direction as well. See how it looks first. I think maybe there, and if we can line this up correctly. Whoop. I think that's about right. We'll get a few going. It's coming along slowly, I think. I think I'm paying a little bit too much attention and too much attention to the details. I'm trying to think forward rather than actually just get the paint on the canvas and do my Bob Ross. I'm glad these are in because they don't hold huge amounts. It'll take a little bit of pressure off this, but when the houses are kind of dotted around here, we've got little town squares. I think it'll be quite good. To the corner of the map, okay. I'm trying to get my bearings a little bit. I think the town hall, because this isn't a large map either, it's a medium map. So we're going to run out of space a little bit quicker than usual. I think we will go with the town hall here. In fact, yeah, we're not going to do it in this episode, but I think it is going to go there. We're going to concentrate on this next episode. I'm going to put some houses in. And we're going to also come over this side. Maybe start looking at some statue carvers as well so we can trade and get that going. And maybe some more houses. How are we doing for those? Four people that are homeless. Yeah, this is definitely going to fix that. Just needs the resources. Might help if I put a road in along the front here. Where can we connect this to? We'll connect it to there. And I don't go completely cross-eyed because of the trees. I think we got a stone pile here, haven't we? Yeah. There we go. And that's ready then. Okay. I'm going to leave the episode there. So until next time, as always, take care.